Everyone, and good evening. Welcome back. This is it. This is the finale of Back to the Future, the game. This will be part 4 of the whole playthrough. This is episode 5 out of time. Let's get started. This map looks familiar. Brainwaves in you. Right on time, yep. Which is fitting for Back to the Future. Hi, Monica. Feeling pretty good, well rested and all that. How about you?
Hello?
Marty, you're awake. Good.
Emmett, where are you?
I'm down at the expo. I snuck out early to avoid my pop. If he knew I was about to make a publicly scientific spectacle of myself, he'd hit the roof.
You let me sleep in?
Why didn't you wake me up?
I tried to give you a nudge before I left, but you were practically comatose. How long has it been since you slept?
Aside from being knocked unconscious, I'm not really sure.
Anyway, I left you back at the lab to perform an important mission. On the table next to my law books, there's a device plugged into the wall.
I think I see it.
Is it glowing?
Yeah, is that good?
Good? It's fantastic! Glowing means my static.
Feeling a little stiff too?
Up and ready for action. Bring it down to the high school and we'll... Damn!
What?
It's Edna!
But...
You didn't move much today?
One static accumulator coming up.
Okay, so what? You wanted me to bring him back this to the expo? I was again just playing Raft? Ah, okay.
Yeah.
Jeez, Doc. Watch out. You almost ran me over.
Sorry about that, Martin. This vehicle is sometimes difficult to control.
Yeah. Hey, are you okay? After that argument about Emmett last night...
I'm fine. Thank you for asking.
Did you fix the time circuits?
So, how are the time circuits?
Still broken. I've got a few ideas, but I'm occupied with other problems today. So, is that what I'm destined to build for the expo?
Yeah, it's a static accumulator. Emmett spent all night building it. Turned out he didn't really need to see Frankenstein after all.
Don't let him touch it.
He needed a little push. And some lightning.
Fascinating. I also had an epiphany last night.
Doc?
I realized that it wasn't Edna that made my life miserable.
It was you!
Doc!
It was science.
I know, it was science. But science means everything to you. Don't let him have it.
You can't give up science. You love science.
Correction. My younger self loves science. But if Emmett doesn't go through with a demonstration at the expo, his dreams of being a scientist will dim just enough for Edna to step back into his life and steer him down another path.
Emmett can't go back to Edna. Don't you remember what she did to you?
You can't want Emmett back with Edna. She used you to turn Hill Valley into a police state.
She used my science to turn Hill Valley into a police state. But if I don't become a scientist, she'll never get the chance to vent her crazier ambitions.
Or she'll do so with another scientist, for all you know.
Another path? What other path?
I don't know. Architecture, automobile repair, taxidermy.
Taxidermy.
Maybe I'll even pursue a life in law like my father always wanted. As long as Emmett steers clear of science, Edna and I will be free to be happy together.
Doc, I'm begging you. You haven't thought this through.
Haven't I? I guess we'll both find out. One thing's for sure. Emmett Brown's life will be a whole lot less complicated without a time machine in it.
No! Ah! What the hell?
And now he's
Where'd
gone.
He go?
Grab Emmett's static accumulator. There it is, I guess.
Oh, come on! Here, little static thingy. I can't reach it.
Huh. Well, I guess I could take the DeLorean. Perhaps, maybe. Instead of being with Edna, you just gotta make her happy with someone else. Problem solved. Yeah, but it's a bit more deeply rooted than that. I think he loves her again anyway, despite all that has happened. Because he sees another side of her. So, seeing her with someone else won't cut it. Yeah, of course.
I can't reach it.
Can't reach it, huh?
Nah.
How do I reach it then? Or should I go in? Oh, climbing the lamppost?
Gotcha!
Well, I got it. It's what matters.
The future is coming today. There's a shiny new tomorrow on the way.
She's back on stage, by the way. She's been allowed to be the muse. Yeah, I'm happy for her.
Not bad, eh? Not bad at all.
I believe it is the voice actress singing.
I found a loophole.
It does sound like her voice.
Kind of loophole.
Impressive.
Just a loophole. You're not the only one who's allowed to have.
Okay, there was a loophole.
All right. Say, don't you have to get that whatchamacallit to Emmett Brown's booth?
Huh? Oh, yeah, right.
Because the future is coming. It's almost here now. The future is coming. It's getting clear now. The future is coming too.
It's kind of sad that she doesn't have more of an audience. She was singing at with all her heart to a mostly apathetic audience.
And here he comes, right on cue. No doubt he'll try to talk you out of it, Detective, but you mustn't let your resolution waver.
Hello, Callahan.
What's Edna up to?
What's she doing here?
Well, Miss Strickland here seems to think,
You should step aside and let the officer do his duty. Now.
Ah, yeah. Preventing Emmett from having his...
Oh, don't be so modest.
Experiment showcased.
I'd say you deserve at least half the credit. It was you who tricked poor Emmett into breaking up with me. It was you who manipulated him into dropping my project in favor of this clear hazard to public safety.
So what?
So what? What's your point?
Oh, I think you know exactly what my point is. Emmett's invention isn't going to work, is it? At least not the way poor Emmett thinks it is.
How do you know this?
I had a very interesting chat with Carl Sagan last night. I found out who Harry Callahan really is, and where he comes from.
Is there something you want to tell me, Harry?
Why don't you call him by his real name?
She doesn't know my real name.
Yakov Smirnoff.
Yeah.
Thanks a lot, Doc.
Thanks a lot, Doc.
An anarchist, a foreign agitator bent on sowing chaos and destruction in the Hill Valley Expo.
Danny, you don't believe any of this bullshit, do you?
Sorry, Yakov, but I really don't have a choice.
Very good.
I wonder if Yakov Smirnov is the name of someone who existed.
Come here.
I never looked it up, but now I'm kinda curious.
I happen to believe this dame's got a screw loose. But she's been getting some clout in town, ever since that business with Kid Tannen.
But Emmett's gotta fly that electrokinetic levitator at this demo. His whole future depends on it.
And my future depends on making sure...
Yeah, apparently he's a Ukrainian... Religiously. Well, comedian or something?
She's gonna start a campaign to have certain tainted...
Interesting. Okay.
From the force.
But yeah, he does exist.
I can do?
Not unless you've got...
Won't be born until 1951, though. Discreditor in the eyes at this point.
Well...
I'll dig something up.
You do that.
You looked it up as well? Oh, okay.
Brown better... Where is he, anyway?
Wait, you haven't seen him?
Emmett? Has this foreign radical done something to my Emmett?
Maybe you should find him.
Oh! You're letting him go? This radical subversive? Just like that?
Okay, so, I gotta find Emmett. And do something about Edna.
If I remember this correctly... Emmett is very close by. He is in here.
It's some kind of deep sea diving thingy. Excuse me, Mr.
Duto, Jacques Duto, at your service.
The name means dubious in French, by the way. Probably hiding since Edna was nearby. No, he's been abducted.
I'm looking for a friend of mine, Emmett Brown. Tall young guy, reddish brown hair.
A distracted look.
That's him. Any idea where he went?
He just passed by here with an older gentleman. I think they were headed into the House of Glass.
Great, thanks.
Find Emmett so that he can demonstrate his invention. But I already know where he is. Well, let's have a look around. All the same. Oh, what is this? Chronometric clock?
I think that's supposed to be a clock.
Interesting design. House of the Future turnstile.
Insert ticket to enter.
What's the House of the Future like?
Hey, Emmett, come out of there. Don't listen to him.
I know, there he is. At this point in time, I guess.
Perfect. Insert ticket to enter.
Can I ask Artie? For some tickets?
Hey, Artie. What do you think? Quite a setup, huh? The expo? Sure, but I was wondering.
Reminds me of the time locket from Harry Potter. Yeah, I guess. Yeah, the clock thing, yeah. Emmett's in the glass house.
Emmett's in the glass house with Carl Sagan.
Then you found him. Oh, good.
It's not good. Sagan's gonna make him miss his demo.
What are you, his mother? I'm sure he can take care of himself.
Is there any way you can delay Emmett's demo? He ran into some last-minute turbulence.
Emmett's already pushed his luck by substituting this electrokinetic what's-this for the mental alignment meter he was supposed to be showing.
You have a poorly made version of this?
On the roster, too. The board would get the idea I was showing favoritism.
Wish it worked, huh? Can you get Emmett's booth back open?
Edna Strickland got Officer Parker to close Emmett's booth down.
What? Why?
She claims his invention is dangerous.
Is it?
That's not the point.
You must be able to get Emmett's booth open.
Is there anything you could do to get Emmett's booth reopened?
I am afraid not. This may be a wondrous land of tomorrow, but it's still within the jurisdiction of the Hill Valley Police Force. Maybe...
Funny enough, from the Harry Potter shop in England, so they sell shoddily made...
As Edna's got clout in Hill Valley.
She does have that.
Harry Potter merchandise at the Harry Potter shop in England. How did Trixie get her job back?
You can tell me. How did you manage to get Trixie her job back? I thought her being Canadian was a deal breaker.
If something's really important to you, you find a way. You ought to know that.
See you around.
This guy can't help. Not now, anyway.
Algae cake!
How about an algae cake?
Sure thing, mister.
It can spin, but it's starting to fall apart even though I have barely used it.
I thought you couldn't stand it.
Hey! You're the guy that tried to pick up on my Eunice!
For the love of...
No algae cakes for you, Buster!
That's great, because I didn't want any. How do I get to that glass house thing? Don't seem to be allowed to go that way. Well, where do I get tickets? That'd be a start. Or maybe information? Maybe she sells tickets.
Hi, Trixie.
That's techni to you, kiddo.
Right. Congratulations on getting the old job back.
Thanks. Justice triumphs in the end, you know? Now what can I do you for?
Tell me about the attractions. Emmett's in the glass house. Yeah, that's the most important thing.
Look, Trixie, I found Emmett. He's in the glass house with Doc, Carl Sagan.
Oh, good. That's nice.
We've got to get him out of there.
Aren't you being a little dramatic? It's an exhibit, not a prison.
Well, I guess if I want tickets, and if she's the one to sell me any or give me any, I have to ask her about
so
the attractions.
Which exhibits do you recommend?
Or exhibits, as it were.
The most popular attractions are the glass house, the future furnishings, and of course, Enlightenment Under the Sea. You know who that is under the diving helmet? That's Jacques Dutoit himself. Of course, you need to get tickets if you want to see the main attractions.
Where can I yeah, there we go. Okay, how do I get tickets?
How much are tickets?
Aw, put your money away. Here, you're kind of like family now, you know?
Thanks.
Yeah, he kind of is.
Look, Emmett's demonstration has hit a snag or two. Can you delay his act for a while? Let someone else go before...
Foreshadowing!
Sorry, I don't set the roster, and they won't let me change it. I can drag my feet a little, but if your friend's not ready to go on pretty soon, we might have to skip his act. Demonstration.
His act.
You can't.
Hey, it's just a science demo. It ain't a matter of life and death.
To you, it isn't. Edna got Emmett's booth shut down.
Edna Strickland is trying to get Emmett's booth shut down.
That dame don't know how to mind her own business, does she?
Well, maybe that now she knows that Edna is involved somehow to get her revenge, she may be willing to help.
Is there anything you can do to get Emmett's booth open again?
I wish there was, but I'm just a muse. All we can do is inspire people.
Inspire me, muse.
Okay, you're a muse. Can you inspire me an idea?
I'll try. Well?
Maybe it doesn't take effect right away.
Maybe that's how muses work. Maybe it's like on a timer or something. Or maybe she sang too much, so now she has to wait for a cooldown or something. Had to get the job back.
You already told me how you managed to get your old job back.
He did? But it was supposed to be a secret.
There's no secrets between us. He couldn't resist telling such a good story.
Yeah?
Still, I'd like to hear it again, from your point of view.
He didn't tell you anything.
Yeah, we're not
Come
about
on,
to
Trixie.
Know. That'd be
know
revealing too much too early.
You won't hear it from me. I don't talk out of turn.
It did. No, it didn't. It did. Maybe. Maybe if they are betrothed, she's about to become an American by marriage. Maybe. So that could be a way to work around the rules. Maybe.
Thanks.
To help.
Or maybe he pretended that he had already married her when he hasn't yet, but I guess we'll find out eventually.
A potted plant? What's this got to do with law enforcement?
A potted plant? What's this got to do with law enforcement?
It's a bug.
No, a plant.
but it's got a wire recorder hidden inside.
Or maybe she's pregnant.
If we could have got one of these
of a soon-to-be American child.
The kind of guy
that'll work, perhaps. Maybe.
Could have busted him a lot earlier.
Are you ready for a picture radio? Wonder if that's anything like MTV.
Not quite. recording device.
Hey, don't walk off with the recording plant. It's the only one I got.
Huh. I may need it eventually, though. Futuristic weapon.
Well, the electro-pacifier.
Amazing, isn't it? They say one day we'll be able to stun fleeing criminals by shocking them at a distance.
Does it work?
Nah, it's just a model.
Well, we got tasers. Close
the
enough.
Amazing inebriomatic.
Well, from what the boys in the lab tell me, someday we'll be able to tell whether people have been drinking just by breathing into a machine like this. Yeah, try it out.
I don't think so.
Keep blowing, mister. Keep blowing. Keep blowing.
We'll be able to stun fleeing criminals by shocking them at a
distance. Go on.
Does it work?
Nah, it's just a model.
Okay.
There was something else I wanted to say. What was it?
A stroll around the expo might do you some good. All right.
Was it? Oh yes.
Well, she gave me tickets. Yeah, let's check out the House of Glass, or however it was called. Glass House, yeah. I really like this. Just amazing, isn't it, about things we are so used to today? Well, that's probably how people of the time would have felt like.
The future of domestic life.
Okay, Emmett, let's get you out of here. Emmett! Emmett, don't listen to him! He's crazy!
I'm still not sure about this business proposal, Mr. Sagan.
Let me explain it again.
Atlas Glass.
Doesn't that create a time paradox or something?
Soundproof glass.
Aren't you supposed to either pass out or create a tear in the very fabric of the space-time continuum or something like that? Now he's just face to face with him and just talking to him. Okay, this is not well thought out, I think. is it gonna be like a giant puzzle? Yeah, what happened to don't meet your own self? Exactly. Maybe now that I've interacted with other stuff. Ah, there we go, okay. I'm not a big fan of that kind of thing. Giant maze of sliding doors like this. This is the house of the future. I don't want to live in it. That's for sure. Yeah, that's how they call it. Or glass house or whatever. House of glass, not future. wait. Why is the music stopping and... And
something's
stuff.
Blocking it.
Upstairs, maybe? I guess very faintly I can hear the sounds of the crowd, but... Yeah, true. I guess that's it, yeah, perhaps. This green panel will be able to slide. Now that this is out of the way. Ah, yeah. This is part of the same panel. Okay. Chloroform. Ah! What now? Or like that, perhaps? Ah, yeah. Yeah, now it should work.
Now, Doc.
Hey, there was a... shit! There was a potted plant that looks exactly like the... microphone flower that the cop has at his exhibit.
Don't forget, you can purchase tickets to our main attractions right here at the information booth.
Yeah, go back into the House of the Future.
Welcome to the world of tomorrow, where a man's home is truly his castle. Here, gratification is just always a push of a button away.
Yeah, take the potted plant.
Doesn't belong here. There's nothing futuristic about it.
Stop enough from interfering with Emmett's demonstration. Sound more excited, will ya?
Fresh fruit baskets will be replenished daily by fleets of fruit-bearing helicopters.
Oh, it's wax.
Yeah, funnily enough, this is the thing that they have in the kitchen in Back to the Future 2 in 2015. Actually,
Hey!
Please recite the phone number you wish to dial, or say, hang up, to terminate your phone helmet experience.
Actually, I think some of these inventions, this one in particular, I've seen it in a black and white video or something, or recording. I don't know if it was from the 1930s, but in like, Life of the Future kind of thing. So I think they've taken inspiration from what they had already imagined for real back then.
4385.
Brown residence.
I'm not entirely sure.
This is Marty, Emmett's friend. Is he there?
Not at the moment. I'm afraid he's off on one of his little adventures.
Thanks. Bye.
Farewell.
Conversation terminated.
I'm more impressed that it works here, though. Like, voice recognition? Working at the time? Doesn't sound likely.
Chinese checkers and everything.
Alright. Now I'm gonna swap the potted flower for the fake potted flower over there. Doesn't even work that well in these times. Well, yeah. I mean, we've made some progress, at least, but... but it's still not 100% working.
Why?
What?
Next up on our roster, a man who saw the possibilities in pond scum. Welcome, Ernest Philpott!
Thanks, Trixie, Technique. I'm truly honored to be here today among all you pointy-headed type people. Like the lady said, I labor in the field of pawn scum.
Excuse me, sir. I'm looking for a tall, thin, older gentleman. He might have been with a tall, thin, younger gentleman.
I know just who you're talking about. Hey, just left about a minute ago. If you hurry, you might catch
that.
I know who you are. You don't even have the same voice as before.
I know you're in there, Doc.
Doc? Yes, I am a doctor, a marine biology, but I fail to understand what you're...
Quit fooling around, Doc. What have you done with
him? Stop! Help! I'm being attacked!
Harry! What are you doing? You can't assault the exhibitors!
Yeah, it's us alright.
He's kidnapped Emmett.
It does kind of look like the character is from Among Us as well.
I'll say he is.
You want I should toss him out on his ear?
That won't be necessary. Do you know who that is? That's Jacques Duteau of the Oceanic Institute.
No, it's not. It's...
Please keep it down. The Expo went through a lot of trouble and expense to secure Professor Duteau. We can't afford to antagonize him.
But
if you've got a complaint against him, we can straighten it out after the show. But if you make another scene like that, I'm afraid I'm going to have you expelled from the hall.
Okay, Grandpa. Professor Duteau.
Professor Duteau, huh?
They pronounce it like 20 different ways, but none of the ways they pronounce it is the right way. But fine, whatever.
What have you done with the real Professor Duteau?
I'm not sure I like your insinuations.
I'm not sure I like you kidnapping Emmett.
Perhaps I should call the authorities.
It's Duteau.
And have you removed from the hall.
You're a cold-blooded guy, Duteau.
C'est la vie.
What did you do with Emmett?
Stash Emmett? In the diving bell?
It's called...
But the character is probably inspired by Jacques Cousteau, which is a real person, but not from 1931, though. He made lots of films on sea life. He spent like millions and millions in buying or even crafting himself like cameras that work on the water to film the ocean life. Especially in the 1970s and 1980s. They still aired his documentaries on TV when I was little. I would watch them with my dad. Let me look in the bathysphere.
I think I'm going to take a closer look at that bathysphere.
Not without a ticket, I'm afraid, sir.
Hey! Is this guy trying to bum a free ride?
But I have tickets.
No.
See that you don't. Feels good to be on the right side of the law.
Take off your helmet.
Take off your helmet.
I prefer to leave it on. The inland air is difficult on my sinuses.
Take a ride in a bathysphere. Your bathysphere. I'd like to see the inside of it.
Can't get in without a ticket, I'm afraid.
But I have tickets.
You're not gonna get away with this, you know.
As they say in my country, que sera, sera.
I believe you're confusing Spanish and French, my friend.
Thank you, Ernest. Do be sure to drop by his booth and sample an algae cake. I have, and it was very interesting. I will be back later to highlight another of our fine exhibitors. See you soon.
Detective Daniel Parker. I do have tickets. Here they are.
Here's my ticket. I want to see inside that bathysphere.
I don't think so.
What do you mean? I've got a ticket. You have to honor my ticket.
It's the wrong kind of ticket. Sorry.
Oh, give me a break. I ought to just go raise the bathysphere myself.
I don't think so.
Is this punk giving you trouble, Mr. Duto?
And here, it's even spelled wrong. Or maybe it was actually the right spelling, and it's the texture here that's not spelled right. In which case, they would be pronouncing it sort of correctly.
You've got to take my ticket and let me into the bathysphere. It's the rules.
If you've got the problem, go lodge a complaint.
Maybe I should. He won't honor my ticket.
Hey, Artie.
Emmett's trapped in the bathysphere. Aquarium guy won't take my ticket. Sure you can't delay Emmett's demo? You must be able to get Emmett's booth open. Aquarium guy won't take my ticket.
Get me into any exhibit on the floor, right?
Sure! That's a P-ticket!
Well, the guy at the aquarium is refusing to honor it.
There must be some mistake. Come on, let's straighten this out.
Thanks, Grandpa.
Professor Duto, this young man claims you refuse to take his ticket.
Not at all. I am only...
Maybe they just spelled it wrong 90% of the time.
Please, climb the ladder, and I will raise the bathysphere.
And it would sound closer to Jacques Cousteau as well.
Mon Dieu! What is the matter? The gears, they must have become stuck. I am afraid I cannot raise the bathysphere at this moment.
What a shame.
Yes, it is, Well, I will work on the problem. Perhaps if you come back later. Come down, please. The bathysphere exhibit is currently closed. Step back! You're crimping the hose!
What's it to you? There's nobody inside, is there?
What does it matter if there's nobody in the bathysphere?
It's very bad form.
Oh, sorry.
If the young Emmett dies, he dies too.
The next exhibit on the list is Officer Danny Parker of the Hill Valley Police Force. Officer Parker is going to demonstrate...
Like I said, it's possible that they just spelled it wrong, but their pronunciation is actually what they were going for, and in which case, yeah, okay, then there's no problem.
Officer Parker? It seems our next exhibitor is unavoidably detained, but I'm...
It's only one letter difference, so...
...enlightening and exciting. How about a round of applause, just for the heck of it?
It's an old nautical superstition. A crimped horse meets imminent doom.
He's dying. Well, or phasing out of reality, I guess.
There wasn't anybody in the bathysphere.
There's not.
I'm not moving.
Hey!
I know, Emmett. Drop the act.
You ready to drop the act now, Jacques Duto, a.k.a.
It's spelled a different way again. I mean, they seem to pronounce it mostly the right way. I mean, most of the time. But it's the spelling that is different, like, practically every time it comes on screen. Raise the bathysphere.
I'm just gonna keep holding this air tube closed until you raise the bathysphere.
I wish you wouldn't.
Well, why not? There's nobody in the bathysphere, right? Emmett gets no air until you raise the bathysphere.
Emmett? Who?
Emmett, you.
Ah, but come on.
I'm just gonna keep holding this air tube closed until you raise the bathysphere.
I wish you...
Well, why not? There's nobody in the bathysphere.
It is the right thing to do. I know there... Eventually, it will be like, alright, you win, or something like that, but...
You ready to drop the act now, Jacques Duto, a.k.a. Carl Sagan, a.k.a...
No!
You know what happens when the air runs out, to both of you.
I command you uncrimp that hose!
I demand you let Emmett out of that bathysphere.
I don't know. What your...
Can't you see he's messing with us? There's nothing wrong with those gears.
Monsieur Duto is doing his best to fix the exhibit. Hovering over him like that doesn't help the situation any.
I command you uncrimp that hose.
I demand you let Emmett out of that bathysphere.
I don't know what you're talking about.
What do I have to do?
Step off!
Not from here. He's too far away.
Wait, what was that?
He's running out of air, Doc. And you're running out of time. Let him out.
I won't do it!
Well, we seem to be getting somewhere, I guess. There is some progress. Okay. I think I've done it.
So Talons, the years, they have become unstuck.
There, see? It was just a malfunction after all.
Let's get you out of there.
Emmett Brown? Then it was true.
He's gone already.
Hey, you.
Hey, he just took that guy's wallet. I think he took his wallet.
That's a line from Back to the Future 2.
I guess I must have a touch of claustrophobia. Never should have gone in there.
Well, we've all got problems. Now, you'd better get back to your booth.
Funny
before...
thing is, I don't even remember going in there. Last thing I recall, I was in the glass.
Yeah, you were put to sleep.
Carl Sagan. Did you know he's really a scientist?
I'd heard. What did he say to you?
Oh, he had some sort of spur-of-the-moment business proposition. It was all very rush-rush. I never got the details. It would have meant leaving before the expo was over, so I told him that... Say, where'd he go? Do you know?
Carl Sagan? He had to leave. One of his experiments blew up on him.
Nah, I know how that is. What's this?
We still gotta get your exhibit reopened.
Parker shut down your booth. He says he can't go against her.
Oh, yeah?
Unless we dig up some dirt that'll discredit her in the eyes of the law. So that's what we'll do.
Stop Edna from interfering with Emmett's demonstration.
Hello, Smirnoff.
Hey, Emmett, mind if I talk to your
Smirnoff.
Ex for a
minute?
Could you? The detective and I need to have a rational conversation about my invention.
Are you implying that I'm irrational?
Come on, Edna.
Worst French accent. Yeah, that's true. Yeah, sorry, I missed that. How did I miss that? But you broke up with Emmett. Why'd you shut down Emmett's booth? It's got the goods. I've got the goods on you. Where's Carl Sagan? Shouldn't I use the... Well, is there a way that I can use the recording, like, fake flower pot?
Have you seen Mr. Sagan around here anywhere?
No, and I wouldn't tell you if I had. He's more than a little scared of your anarchistic tendencies.
Trixie's back in the saddle.
Did you see? Trixie Trotter got her old job back.
Oh, I know! I tried to have it out with Arthur McFly, but he refuses to explain himself. Apparently, he discovered some sort of loophole that allows that Canadian to retain her position. Well, the Ladies' Decency Society shall hear about this. Make no mistake.
The Ladies' Decency Society. Why does Parker take orders from you?
Why is Parker so willing to do your bidding?
Well, the good detective knows that he owes his current rise through the ranks to my reporting on his behalf.
Oh.
He also knows that I could just as easily pen an exposé about his previous nights of drunken debauchery and evidence tampering.
You're blackmailing him?
Reporters don't blackmail, Mr. Smirnoff. We look out for the public interest.
I'm sure. I've got the goods on you. Why'd you shut down Emmett's booth? But you broke up with Emmett.
Why are you still involved in Emmett's life? I thought you broke up with him.
I did, but then your friend Mr. Sagan told me about your scheme to interfere with our romance. Not a very nice thing to do, Comrade Smirnoff.
Emmett doesn't want you back.
You don't really think Emmett's gonna want you back after you crushed his heart and tried to stop his demonstration at the expo, do you?
Not at first, no. But eventually, he'll realize I've got his best interests at heart, and he'll come running back to me like one of those dogs he loves so much.
Yeah, I'm sure you love him, just...
Yes, ironic, isn't it?
Yeah, from how you speak about him. Yeah, right. You don't have his best interests at heart.
Why'd you go and get Emmett's invention sealed up like that?
I had no choice. Once Mr. Sagan told me about your attempts to radicalize my poor Emmett, I knew I had to stop him from going through with your dangerous invention.
But it's his invention, and it's not dangerous. Okay, maybe it's a little dangerous, but only to him.
That's for the authorities to decide.
I know your deep, dark secret.
Secret? What secret?
Rhymes with which? What you were whispering with Carl? You've been working for Katanin? A thief. No, I don't see what how that's got to do with anything. Rhymes with which? What could that be?
You know, what you were whispering about with Carl Sagan yesterday.
You overheard?
Sure I did. And you did a really lousy job at, burying the body.
Oh, you didn't hear a thing. What I was talking about with Carl Sagan is between me and Carl Sagan.
But besides, if I don't record what she's saying...
Soon Emmett and I will have all the time in the world. Oh.
Recording Edna on the plan is a great idea, but I probably should be a little more subtle about it.
Do I have to position the plant somewhere? Now you've got a bug, but where to plant it? Yeah, that's what I was wondering about. Where? Okay, well, before I ask for another hint, maybe I should just look around.
Do my job.
Oh, here perhaps.
Wait a minute, I'm not quite through yet.
I mean, both the two of them come to talk here. No? Oh, well, I don't want to go up the stairs.
I don't think so.
Yeah. Okay, it's not that simple. Or here, perhaps?
Okay, call me a snoop.
Oh! Should I call her on the phone? And pretend to be Carl Sagan? Ah, yeah, that could be. Well, it was Klondike 4235. Is that it?
Welcome to the phone booth of the future, made with Atlas glass. Atlas, unbreakable and soundproof. Our phone is hands-free, so you can enjoy a sandwich or a cigarette while chatting with friends in perfect privacy. Would you like to place a call?
Yes, I'd like to talk to...
Unfortunately, this phone booth only accepts incoming calls.
Well, okay, whatever. If I get it to ring, Trixie should pick up, and then she'll call Edna, I guess.
Welcome to the world of tomorrow, where a man's home is truly his castle. Here, gratification is just always a push of a button away.
Phone. Entertainment? No phone.
In the house of the future, phone conversations will be completed in the privacy of the personal phone helmet.
Please recite the phone number you wish to dial, or say, hang up, to terminate your phone helmet experience.
Phone booth of the future.
Klondike 4253.
Hill Valley Expo, where the future is coming today. This is Checkney Muse of Progress. To whom am I speaking?
Carl Sagan.
This is Carl Sagan.
Ooh,
he makes a good impression.
Mr. Sagan, what do you want?
Can I talk to Edna?
Can you put Edna Strickland on the phone for me?
Sure thing, Mr. Sagan. Hey, Strickland! Somebody actually wants to talk to you.
Mr. Sagan, what happened? I thought you were distracting Emmett.
I was? Oh, yes, of course I was.
Then why is Emmett standing here, valiantly trying to convince Detective Parker that he should be allowed to go through with this ever-so-dangerous display of wrong-headed technology?
What can I say? I was outsmarted by that wily Yakov Smirnoff.
Well, that puts a crimp in our plan.
Yes, yes, our plan. About that plan.
Your dark secret? Where's Emmett? But I guess I should be careful about how I want to approach it so she doesn't get too suspicious.
I'm a little unclear on the details of our plan.
Unclear? But it's your plan.
I mean, I'm worried that you're a little unclear on the details.
You were supposed to keep Emmett distracted, but it appears that you've been foiled by Mr. Smirnoff.
What can I say? He's too smart for an old fogey like me.
So I see.
Regarding, you know what?
You know what?
The little matter we were whispering about yesterday.
Oh, that? As a matter of fact, I'm glad you brought it up. I was thinking, wouldn't it be a good idea to pin it all on Yakov Smirnoff?
I think it's something about the speakeasies being burnt down.
It.
She's the arsonist after all, but...
Oh, I get it. You're still sore about going to jail. That was the dog's fault. If he hadn't come glumping up to me right after I started the fire, I could have gotten clean away. And I never would have had to divert suspicion to you.
She's the speakeasy arsonist.
Carl? Is somebody
with you? No! It's just you and me. You know, I don't think I ever asked you why you burned down all those speakeasies.
Why? Because no one else was doing anything about them. Every night they'd open up their doors serving illegal drinks and loose women, flaunting their depravity to the world. And the authorities did nothing. So I did what any right-thinking, rock-willed woman would do. I took action. Oh, and such a gorgeous action it was, too. The fires were so beautiful. The alcohol made them go up in such pretty blue flames. Where was I?
You were explaining why you burned down the speakeasies.
You pyromaniac.
Did you find my answer to your liking?
It was very revealing. Hang up.
What?
Jeez, Edna was always a loon. I hope that confession's good enough for Parker.
I sure hope so, too.
Hiya, folks. It's me, Techni, Muse of Progress. Gracing you once again with my presence. And speaking of presents, what better gift could Hill Valley offer the world than this magnificent science and technology exhibit, hey folks? If you haven't done so already, I urge each and every one of you to take a peek at Furnishings of the Future, right here in our main hall. Tickets are available from me, Techni, at our information desk.
Time's a ticking. Let's see, recording device.
You know, I don't think I ever asked you why you burned down all those speakeasies.
I think a lot of people are going to be interested in that answer.
Right. With that being the case.
Oh.
Hey, Danny.
Do you mind, comrade?
Comrade.
I'm busy trying to keep Emmett from letting you lead him into the biggest mistake of his life.
Mistake? My biggest mistake was...
This'll only take a minute.
Our plant recorder. It's not a good idea to steal police property, you know.
Shh, listen.
You know, I don't think I ever asked you why you burned down all those speakeasies.
Why? Because no one else was doing anything about them.
Edna? You're the arsonist?
Detective Parker, surely you're not going to believe this crudely manufactured forgery of a recording.
I'm not sure what to believe, ma'am. But based on this crudely manufactured forgery,
I'm afraid I'm gonna have to ask.
I recognize the voice of the policeman now. I know where I've heard it before.
On the night of the speakeasy fires.
Emmett?
You're on your own, darling.
Oh, very well. Heavens, what's that?
You know, one of these days I should really stop falling.
I'll get to it.
Not to sound callous, but does this mean I can demonstrate my invention?
Let's take that as a yes.
He's the voice actor.
Greetings and salutations to all our honored guests. I am Techni, Muse of Progress, and it is my pleasant task once again to highlight one of the great minds who was.
Sorry, I'll look it up in the meantime.
A better tomorrow.
I think that's me. I'm next on the roster.
But are you ready?
No, I don't have a choice. Did you bring the static accumulator?
Oh, right. Here you go.
Great. Come on, let's get up there.
And who knows? One of this kid's gizmos just might take off and change the life of everybody in town. Could it be the very thing he's brought to share with us today?
That ought to do it. Are the block bearings all in the raised position?
Block bearings. Raised position. Check.
Then it looks like all systems are go. Wish me luck.
I don't have to.
Ladies and gentlemen, I give you Emmett Brown.
Objection! Objection, Your Honor. I hereby demand that a scientific demonstration of one Emmett Lethra Brown be terminated and forfeit by reason of insanity. I declare him to be in contempt of me, his father. Where is he? Hand him over this instant. You can't hide from justice. You don't think you can shelter him?
Yeah, hold on. So he's not the voice actor I thought he was, but where I heard it, I was right though. I heard him in the Walking Dead series. I thought he was the voice actor for one of the two cannibal farmers in episode 2 of season 1. But he's actually the voice of the police officer that's taking Lee to prison at the very start of season 1. So he played another police officer in another game by the same developer. So I had heard it before, but not exactly where I thought I had. Be reasonable, you're making a scene.
Come on, Mr. Judge, sir. You're kind of making a scene here.
Wrong. I am stopping my son from making a scene here.
Don't antagonize him.
Well, if you're not going to say anything.
So he is up there with you.
Thanks a lot.
Son, I order you to come down from there this second. I'm counting to fourth.
I'm counting to fourth.
There's no point.
Bite the bullet. He's got to give you a fair trial.
Maybe he'll give you a fair chance to explain yourself. He is a judge, after all.
Yes, a judge who's already passed sentence. He won't listen to me. He never has.
I'll be right back. Emmett.
I'm not talking to him. There's no point.
Just go deal with him. What have you got to lose?
That's what they said to Custer.
Okay. General Custer?
So, what's your plan?
I just stand here like this indefinitely. After a few centuries, the process of petrification will set in, and that'll be that.
Okay, that is a plan. I'll be right back.
Fear! I want to speak to my son!
Emmett's not ready to talk to you, directly.
Oh, God. I suppose you're his mouthpiece?
I guess so, yeah.
You're intimidating him.
If I can say so, sir, the problem is you're coming on too strong. You intimidate him.
I don't intimidate him enough. That's the problem.
His mind is made up. He says you won't listen.
He says it's no use talking to you. You never listen?
That
only shows how pig-headed he is. Of course I'll listen. If he can justify his craziness, I'll be only too happy to indulge it.
Stay right there.
I'm not going
Okay, I
anywhere.
Think that was the first step.
You, Emmett.
I'm not talking to him. There's no point.
He says he'll listen. He promised he'd listen to you.
He said he'll listen to you.
Well,
at least give it a shot.
Father?
Son?
You've never understood the first thing about me. All you want to do is step on me, squelch my natural instincts. You
instincts?
Don't know what it's like
but
to be young.
You understand?
You know
what
it's
like
to be young. Your ambition is so great and so powerful that they've got a life of their own. And it's all you can do to hang on for dear life while they gallop on where they must.
Don't
this is America, Pop. And in America, a person doesn't have to do what his father did. Isn't that why you came to America? To live where there wouldn't be so many rules? Well, we talked. Are you happy?
You both talked, I guess, but none of you were listening to one another.
Please, you gotta get out of Emmett's way.
I have yet to hear a compelling or even coherent reason why.
Why? It's important to the future. Emmett's not like other people. It's important to Emmett.
See, Your Honor, it's just that this demo is so important to Emmett.
A childish kerfuffle. He'll forget all about it in 2 weeks' time.
That's what I'm afraid of. Emmett's just...
stubborn, willful, single-minded, incorrigible, and obsessed.
Talking is the first step to patch things
but
up, but that was yelling without listening to
those
each other.
Traits are kinda... good.
That may be your angle, Sonny, but I'm not so sure it's the right one. Make no mistake, those are traits that lead to trouble. He gets them from his mother.
Look, Your Honor, you don't see it, but there's an awful lot riding on Emmett's demonstration.
All the more reason why I've got to put a stop to it. Look me in the eyes, young man. I expect you know my son pretty well by now. Do you seriously think his exhibition is going to be a success?
I think it
sure.
will.
Sure it will.
Ha! You know as well as I how it'll end. Disaster!
Maybe, and maybe not, but even if it does, I mean, isn't Emmett entitled to make a few mistakes?
Emmett has exceeded his quota for one lifetime. It's my job as his father to see to it there are no more mistakes.
Emmett's different from you. He needs freedom.
Emmett's just trying to make a name for himself. Maybe things were different when you were a kid, but nowadays you gotta take chances.
What do you know about taking chances? Try moving to a strange country where you don't speak the language with only $2 to your name.
You?
You bet your socks, me! And I made out all right, too.
How'd your dad feel about it at the time?
Papa? He was fit to be tied. He called me a disobedient little...
Your father didn't understand you either.
So your father didn't approve of you coming to America?
Well, Papa never really understood the younger generation.
Don't you think you're making the same mistake?
The end, but by then, it was too late to. Tell him I'll listen to him. I want to listen to him. If he wants to talk.
Give it another try, Emmett.
Play peacemaker again, Pollyanna.
Pollyanna. I'm not sure what reference it is. He says you're like your mother. He only yells because he loves you. His bark is worse than his bite. It might seem impossible, but it's not. His bark is worse than his bite.
Okay, so he's got a strong personality.
Strong personality. Lord save us from strong fathers. Why couldn't I have been born to a nice, wimpy milk toast?
Yeah, well, that's no picnic either. The important thing is, fathers can change.
Says you.
Deep down, he's just worried about you hurting yourself.
No amount of physical pain could equal the pain he's already inflicted to my spirit.
I don't know what to say at this point.
Well, that's the limit. He's not satisfied with insulting me. He's got to drag my mother through the dirt, too.
Mother isn't at all like me. She's gentle and sweet and endlessly patient. If anything, I'm more like... Don't skip it.
You're more like him. What did you just say?
You were starting to say that you're like...
Skip it.
Is he the you and your dad?
No.
Have more in common that you're willing to admit?
Stop being a dope. You got your pride. Okay, I get it. And so does he. But what's the harm in trying to make peace with the guy? He's your family, and family's important. Sometimes it's, well, even more important than we realize.
May I come up?
So, you think my new invention is a disaster waiting to happen?
Yes, yes I do. And I'm here to say, if any son of mine is going to make of himself a public disaster, I insist on being there to support him.
Pop! You're gonna change your tune once you see this baby go airborne. You see, the force field generated by the static accumulator. Marty, give Trixie the signal. We're ready for liftoff.
Oh, good. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for bearing with us through that unavoidable delay. And now the Hill Valley Expo is pleased as punch to present Mr. Emmett Brown and his electro.
The new timeline will
levitator.
Actually make them be happy like a family. That's so freaking cute. Yeah, things may not go back exactly to where they were before, but they should mostly be for the best. Ah, history has changed. History has changed already. His invention works this time. He didn't make a complete fool of himself. Or well, maybe it'll still fail. I don't know. Okay, he crashed in the end, but it worked for a little bit.
Hey, stop! Get back here!
Stop! Are you okay?
I thought I could change her. Things could be different.
Forget about it. Come on, we gotta find a way to stop her before...
No, don't come any closer!
This version of Doc is disappearing because he never became like that.
Oh my God, Doc! Say something.
Chromium, lithium, potassium. Iridium, titanium, ruthenium.
I'll get help.
Newspaper.
What? You mean?
Local inventor presented with key to the city.
Gonna get you to a hospital, Doc. You're gonna be okay.
Yes. Oh, I think I am going to be okay, Marty.
No, come on, Doc. Doc, don't do this. Don't go. Doc, come back.
Science! I have science!
Marty, have you been out here the whole
missed
time?
Missed something fun inside, yeah.
Emmett, is it over already?
Oh, it's over all right. You missed a very wild party. I'm afraid I've been banned from the expo for the next 50 years. And if I were you, I wouldn't go back in either. At least not until all the broken glass is swept up. Oh, what was I thinking?
I wouldn't call it a fail. It worked for a little while.
An electromagnet of that size is going to play havoc with a merely mechanical steering mechanism. We need a much more advanced control system. I wonder if we could find a way to translate the body's own gravitational field into electrokinetic force. One might be able to direct the ionic current simply by shifting one's weight. Well, great Scott, that's it!
What about your failed demo?
And you're not discouraged?
Unbreakable glass, was it?
Discouraged?
I guess it wasn't as unbreakable as they thought.
You mean what happened in there? Oh, that was a learning experience. The way I see it, it's those little mistakes along the way that advance us along the pathway of knowledge. Come on, there's no time to lose. Let's get back to the lab and... I'm sorry, is something wrong?
I guess, yeah.
It's a long story. Let's just say I lost somebody.
Oh, how sad. Anyone I know?
Carl Sagan, the future mayor. Nobody you know?
It was, Carl Sagan.
What? The guy who tried to hire me in there? You were friends with him? Strange. But how?
Don't worry about it. It's got nothing to do with you. What?
You're a complete mystery to me, Marty. Where you come from, what you're doing here. But there's one thing I do know. Whatever it is, it does have something to do with me.
Please, Emmett, don't ask
any... What's this? Come on, let me see. I deserve an explanation.
Okay, here goes.
What's that?
An explanation. But you've got to promise me, don't look at it until you get the key to the city.
Huh?
Emmett!
Just promise.
Emmett, where are you, my son?
Key to the city? I don't understand.
And you can't understand. Not for a long time. It would do irreparable damage to something. Just say you promise.
Okay, I promise. Wait, I will see you again, right?
Someday.
I guarantee it.
Emmett!
This is honestly a really good story, like, holy hell. It's not over yet. Not completely.
Hey, it worked.
Marty!
So, you were the same Marty. Funny how memory can play tricks on a person. I remembered you being much taller.
How was the ceremony?
Long. You've got a theatrical way of sending messages.
Only way I could do it without messing up your timeline.
Very clever. But what are you doing in 1931?
I came to restore your path. I came to stop you from marrying Edna.
Edna Strickland? I could never marry her. I mean, she was my first love, but after she broke my heart and tried to sabotage my career, I never...
I wonder if he ended up marrying Clara now that everything has been kind of messed up, I guess.
That is, unless your presence has caused any other time anomalies.
Me? Nah, no. Well, I'm still a little confused about my...
Ah, there we go.
Where is he? Where is that no good son of mine? He's not worthy of the McFly name. Do you see my Artie anywhere?
This is the real Michael J. Fox voicing the character here, by the way.
Just got a call from Melvin at the city records office. He tells me the dad blamed Fool's gun and got himself hitched to a Canadian floozy. Can you believe it? Hitched? Married. I swear, that boy's gonna put his papa in an early grave. So that's how she got her job back. Ah! He's married the wrong grandma.
They managed to get him for that little role.
And if she's not my grandma, I'm not me.
And a few extra little things in this episode, but not much more than that.
He peed on me.
Back to the Future 3.
Doc, I'm gonna disappear again.
Calm down, Marty. You seem reasonably solid right now. Whatever the problem is, I'm sure we can undo it with the help of
that car. Oh, great.
How the hell did she get back here?
She?
You? You're not Edna. What's going on here? Is this some plot to put me in the nut house?
No, it's
yeah, he saw two DeLoreans once.
Sure it is. Tell me, did I or did I not just chase Edna Strickland off in this car?
Not this exact car, but a car just like it.
A car with a nasty habit of disappearing into thin air?
Well,
Trixie was never her name after all. Yeah.
If that's what you call it, it made a loud noise, and then wham! Nothing!
Great Scott! Marty, do you have any notion what date she might have jumped to?
None at all, Doc. See, that DeLorean's time circuits are out of whack. They could jump to any date at all.
Oh, this is bad. This is very bad. Let's just hope she jumped into the future. The far future. If she's jumped into the past.
You think she might mess up the time stream? Wait a minute. This is Edna. Of course she would mess up the time stream.
Guys, you mind telling me what the hell you're...
Uh-oh.
Uh-oh. Uh-oh. Well, hey, Panda. How's it going today?
Doc? Did we just leave Hill Valley?
No, I believe Hill Valley just left us.
How?
Something must have happened to it. A long time ago.
Hayesville Mercantile.
Well, now you two look at my lost. Hey, what on earth is that thing?
It's an experimental vehicle. Pay it no mind.
Look, maybe you can help us.
Where is Hill Valley? Your son, and not Canadian.
Did your son just marry a Canadian saloon singer named Trixie?
Artie? Pshaw, that boy ain't got nerve to ask a girl to the church social. You acquainted with him?
Only slightly.
Oh, we're just passing through. We hope.
We're just passing, though.
We're looking for Hill Valley.
Well, which is it, a hill or a valley?
No, it's a town. It's a town called Hill Valley.
Hill Valley a town? Say, I think I once heard that there was a town here a long time ago. Don't know much about it, though.
Just as I suspected.
When did Hill Valley go away? What happened to Hill Valley? Who destroyed Hill Valley?
Did someone make Hill Valley disappear?
Oh, heck, I don't know. That was all before I was born.
Then whatever it was must have happened at least 45 years ago.
In this case, it really is. Yeah.
Here nowadays. My dad tried to buy a farm in this area years ago, but he got run off by Scary Mary.
Scary Mary?
Well, that's what we all call her. Lives a couple miles from here. I make a monthly drop at her place. She's a fiend for news. Takes all the papers in the county, never throws one away. Say, if there's anybody who can tell you what happened to Hill Valley, it's her.
Can you direct us to her?
It's imperative that we talk to her.
Sorry, fellas, but I'm pretty sure she won't talk to you.
Can you make her talk? I can get her to talk. Yeah. Well, can you
help us
make
with
her talk?
The thing of it is, guys, Mary's older than dirt, but she's also a little touched, if you catch my drift. She doesn't like strangers.
I'm sure we can handle her.
We'll be very polite. Please, we gotta see her.
Well, okay, if you insist. Take a right turn just after the bridge, then follow the wheel ruts till they come to an end. You'll have to go the last quarter mile on foot. Good luck, and don't say I didn't warn you. I got a notion I'll be kicking myself for sending you up there.
Yeah, they couldn't get Michael J. Fox for the entire series. I don't know if it's because he felt he was busy or if it was because of his condition. I believe voicing this much content may be a bit tricky for him with his disease. But it's cool that they managed to get him, even if it's for a small role.
Mary Pickford.
That's the old DeLorean.
Go away! Wipe your feet!
Yeah, that's kind of contradictory. Find out what happens to Hill Valley.
An old saloon sign. Cool. Too bad it's all burnt.
It's a kind of country sounding version of one of the Back to the Future themes.
Look! Look!
What's up with that?
Look!
I'm not quite sure what that's supposed to
Look.
Be. What? It's the DeLorean.
Look!
Beware of cats.
Mary Pickford.
Blacksmith sign?
A blacksmith sign. I wonder if it's from Doc's old shop.
What was that? Ah, yeah, he's picking things up. Outhouse.
Look!
But what? Hey, I can't even inspect some of these things.
I'm guessing this mop doesn't get much use.
Whoops. A clay hoven? There's tripwire, it looks like. Can I talk to him? No, I don't want to look at it. I want to talk to the doc.
What do you see?
This vehicle has sustained some serious damage.
Way to stay focused, Doc. What do you see?
This vehicle...
Okay, it's the same thing. Frisbee's pie.
Pardon us for intruding, madam. We were wondering if you could tell us...
I don't talk to hooligans!
On a very friendly sort.
Doc,
look, Professor, a hint coin.
Impossible.
This is how she was when I first met her. I had to... Listen, just leave it to me.
Okay, you think you know how to handle her. Just remember, we need to know what happened to Hill Valley, and just as importantly, the precise time when it happened.
Window. Hey, there's a photo of Marshall Strickland.
Edna's grandfather, Marshall Strickland. That's the same picture I saw in Edna's apartment, way back, in the future.
Hey, way back in the future. Harry Callahan, Yakov Smirnoff. Yeah, I guess she would know me by the name Yakov Smirnoff.
Yakov Smirnoff?
That's a foolish name! And I make it a rule not to talk to strangers with foolish names!
But we're not strangers!
How do I know you?
You tried to have me arrested once. I saved your life once. You interviewed me once.
You interviewed me once, back when you were young.
Listen, Sonny, I'm an easygoing woman, but I got a few rules I live by. And rule number one is, I never, ever talk about the past! Or the future, neither. I don't talk about any day but today.
I guess that didn't go so well.
Of course she doesn't talk about the past, because there's something in her past she's trying to forget. But we're gonna pry it out of her. Go ahead, knock on the door again.
What?
It's me again, your old friend.
How do I know you?
We spent today together. Probably. Wait, what? Well, I guess it's kind of true. Today is the day of the expo, actually. So, it's factually right.
We spent the day together.
We did? Where?
At the expo.
That's crazy. I've been here all... What day is it?
Tuesday, October 13th, 1931.
October 13th, 1931. October 13th. Something funny about that date.
She's not speaking in the thing anymore, but her voice still sounds as if she was talking into it. Yeah, that's that's something they didn't pay attention to. I couldn't help but notice. I know who you are. Where is Hill Valley? I brought something for you.
I brought something for you.
What is it? Let me see.
Okay, she's still at the window, I take it? Yeah. The expo tickets to show her.
I brought you these tickets to the expo.
Yeah, remind her about remind her of the expo.
You left when you swiped the DeLorean and jumped back in time.
Stop messing with my brain.
And now it sounds like as if she's not talking through it.
And what's more, I never talk about the past.
Do you remember the recording device?
I brought you this.
There's still the recording on it.
Flowers.
Wait till you hear.
And I especially ain't interested in talking flowers. Put them away.
How do you know they're talking flowers?
Were you expecting anything in particular?
I wasn't expecting you.
Ah. Okay.
You've got a nice cactus here.
Quit beating around the bush!
Do you mind if I use your outhouse?
Yeah.
Wait. Ah, crap. Yeah. Stupid Windows thing. No, no, because I was holding down some keys.
I can wait.
Nah, no, never mind. Never mind. You're holding down too many keys or something. Yes, if you press the shift key 5 times, it does something in Windows. It's really annoying.
Were you expecting anything in particular?
I wasn't expecting you. I ain't got all day!
Ah, crap. Knock, knock. What? Where is Hill Valley? I know who you are,
come on,
Edna
Miss Strickland.
Miss who?
Strickland. You're Edna Strickland.
Take a look at the mailbox, Sonny. Name's Pickford. Mary Pickford. And it has been for as long as I care to remember. And like I told you, I don't care to remember!
Where's Hill Valley?
Listen, lady, you've got to tell us where Hill Valley went.
Hill Valley? You're standing in Hill Valley. Population 1.
Well, which suits her? No hooligans that way. It was here once.
But there used to be a regular town here, right?
Might be there was a town once long ago, or might be it was in the future. How many times I gotta tell you, I don't talk about any time but today!
You stole that DeLorean.
You see that car over there? You stole that from Carl Sagan, and you time jumped into the past.
Me? Steal a car? You got a lot of nerve, Sonny. Everyone in town knows that Mary Pickford's the most law-abiding citizen that Hill Valley's ever had. And I don't give a fig about the past.
I guess I've got to show her something.
Let me see.
I brought you this.
Already got one.
We must have brought something Edna wants.
Don't look at me. I didn't bring anything but myself.
Already at part 3, I see. Hi, Quilix. It's the final part. So we'll be done tonight.
I brought you this.
Already got one.
Huh. George McFly? Give Doc to Edna?
I brought you this picture.
Who's that?
Oh yeah, you definitely Quilix. How's it going, by the way?
Like this guy you did know.
Not interested.
I brought you this.
Yeah, she already said that.
And I especially ain't interested in talking flowers. Put them away.
A mop? Already got one.
I brought you this.
Already got one.
Yeah.
We must have brought something Edna wants.
Don't look at me. I didn't bring anything but myself.
I have too much work, but I can kind of relax in the evenings. Well, there's that at least. Mailbox? Is there anything about the burned out DeLorean? Wanna be a student again? Don't we all?
I hate to see it like this.
Okay, a hint, perhaps. To at least put me on the right track. Because I doubt it's anything I already have in my inventory. Edna refuses to talk about any day but today. I don't have a newspaper, do I? That's okay, today's given you plenty to talk about. Explain to Edna, you've already talked to her today. I tried that. The window remains open. Do some stupid homework and then have the rest of the day for playing and dreaming.
You see that car over there? You stole that from Carl Sagan, and you time jumped into the past.
Me? Steal a car?
We've already been through that. If you could go back to the past, would you prefer to keep your mind as an adult or relive it as a child again? I think I'd want to keep my memories.
What is it? Let me see.
I think the hints are not going to be any help. Oh, maybe I should talk to the doc.
I brought you him.
Ah, yeah.
Him ho.
You were right, Panda, perhaps. It's Carl Sagan. Or Emmett Brown.
Look hard. Don't tell me you don't recognize your own boyfriend.
My boyfriend?
Yeah, he's all grown up.
Come closer, fella.
Marty, what am I supposed to do?
Trust me, Doc. Just go with it.
Hey, Panda was right.
It can't be! Emmett!
Yes, Edna. It's me.
turned around. Have I been dreaming? Well, stay there.
It's a classic case of repressed memory syndrome. Once the mental dam is broken, the subject is immediately plunged into the midst of the very scenes she's trying to forget.
Well done with the voice
darling,
acting.
You've come back. Of course I knew you would. An intelligent boy like you wouldn't be one to throw away true love all because of a silly quarrel. I've already forgotten about last night's little tiff. I trust you've done the same?
Of course I have.
Of course I have. What?
He doesn't remember. Schnookums? Sweet stuff? Baby face? Schnookums.
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 Oh, lovey-dovey.
But you're still keeping company with this Smirnoff character. I insist you drop him. He's a bad influence. And you've got to stop working on that dangerous electrokinetic... what's...
Okay.
I suppose now you're miffed with me for forcing Detective Parker to close your booth down. Bitter medicine for you, I know, but I had to do it. And Parker had no choice but to obey my orders. He knows that my opinion carries a lot of weight in Hill Valley, and he'd never... Parker would never... Oh!
What is it?
I don't know. Something about Detective Parker. Something that happened to me on October 13th. What could it be?
Can you jog her memory? If we can keep her mind in the past, we may get the full story of Hill Valley's premature destruction.
I don't know, a mop?
I brought you this.
Already got one.
She says the same thing as when she was at the window. Marshall Strickland.
Edna's grandfather, Marshall Strickland. That's the same picture I saw in Edna's apartment, way back, in the future. Here's something that'll make you remember.
Remember what? I don't like to remember.
Yeah,
who are you?
Maybe
what
I just have to talk
in
to
my
her.
Yard, you hooligan!
No, Edna, no yard.
What?
This is Emmett speaking. It's October 13th. 1931.
Yes.
And something's about to happen.
Oh, yes, something big. But what?
Better not talk to her directly. It'll break the spell.
Not talk to her directly.
Maybe this'll take you back.
Back where? I don't want to go back.
Stay in the moment, Edna. Please, Marty, don't interrupt the trance.
It does seem like I have to use items.
Maybe this will take you back.
Please, Marty, don't.
Edna's trying to remember a traumatic incident initiated by Officer Parker. You know what that is, right? Oh, the flowers?
You know, I don't think I ever asked you why you burned down all those speakeasies.
Why? Because no one else was doing anything about them.
No! Turn it off, you imbecile! If Parker hears that, he'll... Officer, I can explain. It was a trick. I was...
Okay, she sees him in the cactus now.
He's after me! Ha! He'll never catch me in this souped-up car of the future! Curses! I can't shake him! Well... no use in holding back now. Let's see what this baby can do. And here it comes.
Yeah, she is nuts.
Here what comes?
I don't know. Something really unexpected is supposed to happen right about now, but I'm not sure what. Well, come to think of it, how can I be expecting something unexpected? What's going on?
Quick, Marty. We've got to find a way to push the storm.
A flash of light.
Before she snaps out of her reverie.
Hold on a minute.
Maybe not.
No?
Not sure what that'll...
I wanted to set it on fire. Shorter lights, maybe that'll jog our memory, but no.
I wonder what's cooking.
Oh, is there something inside?
Upset her, Marty.
I guess this isn't the right time to be burning things.
I thought it was the perfect time.
Not sure what that'll do.
Maybe bring the fire stick to the car? Maybe. I can't move, though, while I'm holding it.
Not sure what that'll do.
Yeah, I can't move my character at this point. I believe this is what I have to do at some point, but not now. Yeah. I think I'll have to do that, set the outhouse on fire, but not now.
Suppose the flux capacitor still works.
I build my parts sturdy, but not that sturdy.
Yeah, which is funny, considering the DeLorean has already sustained a stay in the mine from 1885 all the way to 1955, sorry. And it was fine then, but this time it only traveled, well, a bit less than that, and it's like all rusted. But no, it's her. It's her that I want to interact with. Okay. Edna needs a prompt to relive the sight of sound of a time jump. Yeah. Something here that makes flashes and bangs. Trigger Edna's alarm system to stimulate the time jump. Ah, okay. The tripwire.
Here they come! The lights! I'm being transported!
Where?
Back! Back! To the past!
What do you see?
Hill Valley! But it's all different. It's so small and primitive. Heavens! Can it be? It is!
My grandpa!
Grandfather! Big as life!
Marshal James Strickland came to
It wasn't signed the mine. It might not have been exposed to the elements as much, while this one is out in the open. Remember? Yeah. But that's still a very dramatic difference, I'd say.
Look like that. That man is an imposter. I'm not even sure.
But yeah, I guess it hasn't been raining on it. It was covered in a tarp or something. Yeah. Yeah, that's fair.
Get off my lawn, you kids.
The tires were all torn though. On the one that stayed in the mine.
Maybe this will take you back.
Please, Marty.
Like what?
Help me figure something out.
Yes?
Marshall Strickland?
How am I supposed to bring back Marshall Strickland?
The photo.
The cactus was him for a few seconds.
Yeah, the picture.
She's not that picky.
Explain something to me, Doc. Edna jumped to the past and made Hill Valley disappear, right?
That's the working hypothesis.
Then how come we're still around?
Whatever Edna did to Hill Valley must have happened so long ago that the ripples in the time stream haven't caught up with us yet.
So how long do we have before the ripples catch up with us?
Oh, I'm sure we've got at least an hour before everything goes to hell.
Great.
That seems a bit arbitrary, but okay, I'll accept it.
If we restore the timeline, I'll never be born, right?
Probably not.
But even if we do restore it, my grandpa's gone and married the wrong woman. Either way, I'm hosed.
One crisis at a time, Marty. Right now, let's worry about getting the full story out of Edna.
Edna used the DeLorean to jump into the past. I wonder why she never jumped out again.
She may not have...
herself in her shoes.
Yeah.
Unexpectedly propelled into the past by an unreliable time machine. Would you risk another trip?
I might.
Could the DeLorean tell us when she landed?
Maybe we could check the time circuit.
Yeah, I don't think so. None in the state that
we
they are.
Could, if there's anything left of the time circuits, but I'm afraid they rusted out long ago.
When do you think it died? The DeLorean, I mean.
That vehicle hasn't been operational in a very long time. My guess is whatever happened to Hill Valley also happened to it.
You know, I've been dealing with Edna Strickland a lot lately, and I've seen her old and I've seen her young, but I've never seen her so...
batshit crazy?
How'd you get like this?
How do you think Edna got this way?
I guess that Edna's immense guilt over whatever she did in the past, combined with the trauma of traveling through time, has caused her to repress her memories. If we want to find out what happened, we'll have to break through those blocks, preferably before the time ripples catch up with us.
You really think we can get through to Edna? She seems pretty... out there.
Even the most repressed memories can be restored with the appropriate stimulation.
Yeah, yeah, okay, I'll get the picture then.
The right cues to lead her.
I get the picture, and I'll get the picture.
We get erased by the time stream.
Sure, no problem.
It's disorienting enough under the best of circumstances. Imagine the effect on a mind that's completely unprepared, especially a mind that doesn't deal well with chaos.
I still can't believe my grandpa married Trixie. What are we gonna do about that?
It's a dire situation, but I'm afraid I'll have to take a backseat to unraveling this unspeakable catastrophe.
That's another fixes to the timeline that they had to deal with. All in all.
Edna's grandfather, Marshall Strickland. That's the same picture I saw in Edna's apartment, way back, in the future.
Can I get it inside her house to grab it?
It's locked.
Ah. Okay. Apparently I can't get the picture.
Maybe this will take you back.
Please, Marty.
Okay. Edna will revive her arrival in the 19th century if she can see her grandfather again. What did Marshall Strickland look like? He had a mess. Ah, wait. I think I've got it. Like, put the mop. Like, the head of the mop on the cactus. Yeah, it said something about... The
he looks a bit like grandfather now, but he would never have.
Yeah, I need a hat, I know. Where am I gonna find one? Edna's hat. Ah, yeah.
This hat doesn't frame her face very well.
Okay, it was on the ground 2 seconds ago.
Not bad.
Oh, grandfather, how well you look. How well everything looks.
How does everything look? Tell me.
It's a bit rustic to be
always
sure.
Resorting to violence.
The buildings are so sturdy.
What
and well
about breaking the window?
The young people of Hill Valley, they're so virtuous and upright. So unlike the degenerate specimens from the 20th century, and I know the reason why.
Why?
They haven't yet fallen prey to the vices of booze and debauchery. They are still in a state of innocence.
If they need to shower, okay.
I think I could learn to like living here. But who's this?
Who?
This big lout swaggering up the street, lips curled in an insolent sneer. He's a newcomer to Hill Valley. Beauregard.
Ah, that's from the animated show. That was from an episode of the animated show Back to the Future.
Tannen.
Yes.
Good guess.
Look at him. Acting like a big shot. Throwing his money around. Stolen money, no doubt. Why can't they see through him? The two-bit phony. And now his plan becomes clear. He's bought a plot of land in town. He's going to put up a...
Let me guess. A saloon?
I don't know. It's something I don't like. Something evil.
This is the key to our mystery. We've got to get her memory back in the groove.
Let me guess. This...
Maybe this will take you back.
Please, Marty.
What?
The trance.
Or do I have to put it on the cactus or something?
Not sure what that'll do.
Okay. Or on the house? Window. No, that's not it. I'm not sure what that'll do. It's probably something to do with the sign, but... And now post Beauregard Tannen's building project. What kind of establishment does she hate the most? I know which type it is. It's the saloon. It's got something to do with the sign, but... Where do I put up the sign? On the outhouse, perhaps? Wait, hold on. I haven't tried that yet. Ah. There
Talk
we go.
About a watering hole.
A saloon?
Watering
in
hole.
Hill Valley? Oh, he can't do that! Grandpa, you can't let him do it! You can't let that snake ruin paradise! Well, if they're all too blind to stop him, I'll just have to take the law into my
own. And she burns down the saloon like she burnt down the speakeasies.
Never opens its doors. I don't know what I'll do, but I'll do something.
And maybe that set the whole town on fire, forcing people to leave. If the fire spread from the saloon to the rest of the town. That's probably it.
Never burn like that.
Let a pro handle it.
First, we'll need some kerosene. Apply it liberally to the building site. No sense in being parsimonious. And now, watch. Isn't it beautiful? The devil's handiwork consumed by the fires of righteousness.
Arsonist. Pyromaniac.
Burn, you sucker! Burn!
She was never this passionate when we were dating.
What
is it, Edna? Is it the fire?
Turn away! Don't look!
It's not staying in the saloon, is it?
Yeah.
It's spreading to the other buildings in Hill Valley.
The whole town burnt down.
It wasn't supposed to happen like this.
But it did happen like this. And you've been repressing it all these years because you can't stand to admit that you're...
A hooligan. I'm a hooligan.
Poor woman, though.
Did I lay it on too thick?
Here's the story. Black and white and red all over.
Huh? Hill Valley destroyed by fire. Started approximately 2 a.m. July 17th, 1876.
Of course, I'm not the real criminal in this story, am I, Mr. Sagan? You set me up for a fall. You and Smirnoff. You made me steal your infernal car. You made me burn down Hill Valley. And now, by the powers invested in me by the town of Hill Valley, I hereby sentence you two criminals to... You! How much have you heard?
Enough for a month's worth of headlines in the Hayesville Herald. 2 months worth if you shoot those fellas.
I could shoot you too, you know.
But you won't, because that would be against the law. And you never break the law, right?
Don't kill William Watt McFly.
Right.
Much obliged.
Phew. Saved by Michael J. Fox.
There's Beauregard Tannen's half-finished saloon. Sometime during the next hour, Edna's going to light it on fire and accidentally burn down Hill Valley.
I wonder where her DeLorean is.
We'll find it later. Right now, we've got to stop that fire. I'll go around back. You go through the front.
Got it.
Stop Edna from accidentally burning down Hill Valley. I still got a blacksmith sign for whatever reason. Do you want a recording device? Oh, this is Beauregard Tannen himself.
I think I liked it better on the outhouse door.
Well, he's that way. But the game isn't letting me leave that way. Maybe she won't burn down the saloon if she thinks it's a blacksmith. Good thinking.
Not sure. I guess she's
not completely batshit crazy at this point in time, so she won't be deceived by a blacksmith sign stuck over a Palace Saloon Hotel sign, I guess. Yeah, bear in mind that at this point, she only just came to the past from 1931, so she's not gone completely crazy yet. I mean, she was already pretty far out, but...
I'd better not get too close.
A pickle barrel. Or barrels, in the plural.
I'd better not get too close. I'd better not get...
I want to get on those barrels, or what am I supposed to do if not that? I can't get the lantern. A window? Okay, it says window... Oh yeah, but I guess this is supposed to be a window, the opening, but knock him out with the sign. I'm gonna have to go say goodbye downstairs.
Who's there?
Edna, stop. It's just me.
Mr. Sagan, what are you doing here?
I was gonna ask you the same question, Miss Pickford.
Isn't it obvious? I'm putting an end to your den of iniquity before it starts.
Okay, I'm gonna have to pause it. Nice looking saloon. Well, it's only being built at the moment, so it's not finished yet. I'll be back in a few minutes. Bear with me, please. Okay, sorry about that. I'm back. Let's finish this now. Uninterrupted, hopefully.
I don't think so, Mary. I don't like shooting women, but no one comes between Beauregard B. Tannen and his livelihood.
Tannen, stop! If you shoot her, she'll drop the torch and this whole place will burn up. Edna, stop! If you drop that torch, he'll shoot us!
Looks like we're at something of a standoff here, Mr. Tannen.
I don't see a way out unless somebody manages to disarm both of you at the same time.
How the hell am I supposed to do that? Hang in there, Doc. Cripes, it's no wonder the town went up. I can smell the kerosene from here.
Kerosene can? There seems to be a glass or something on the counter.
That must be where Edna got the kerosene.
Tacky painting.
Dolores Miskin?
It looks a bit like Trixie.
What kind of odds would you...
Dolores Miskin?
Yeah, sort of.
If I don't figure out some way of dousing that flame, Edna's gonna burn down the town. Chandeliers right over their heads. That's gotta be useful somehow.
Oh, this way? Sandbag.
Man, this thing is not light.
A ladder.
Why are you so hellfire determined to me?
I'm not sure if what I'm doing is the right thing, but it's all I can think of right now.
It's right over his head, but I can't knock him out while Edna's still holding that torch.
Can I jump on it?
There's a sandbag over Tannen's head. I wonder if I can get something over Edna's torch.
Well, can I cross to the other side?
Are you here to haul me back to 1931 for my supposed crimes? Or is there some sort of time court for that kind of thing?
Time court? What in the name of Ulysses S. Grant is she talking about?
Not quite.
Down the ladder then, I guess. I can't...
Man, this thing is not light.
Yeah, I can't take this upstairs, I guess.
Pickle juice. That ought to be handy for putting out torches. It's too heavy to lift.
Say, that's a lovely chandelier you've got there, Tannen. Is it French?
French? Nah, I got it off a wagon that had the misfortune.
I see the father of Bufford Mad Dog Tannen is as much of a criminal as his son. Yeah, no, there's no use in dealing with that now. I don't see why.
Not sure what that'll do.
Exactly, yeah.
Not quite. The sandbag's right over Tannen's head. If I don't figure out some way of dousing that flame,
Yeah, but I did
why
find
are you
a way.
Dressed like that?
I wasn't planning on visiting the 19th century today.
To save Doc in Hill Valley, you'll have to disarm Tannen and douse Edna's flame simultaneously. Dousing is the bigger challenge. You'll need something wet to douse the flame. I already know what I need. Take a look at the barrels outside the window. Yeah, I did.
And I wasn't planning on shooting a couple of lunatics today. Guess life's full of surprises, ain't it?
Pickle juice. That ought to be handy for putting out torches. It's too heavy to lift.
Say it three times fast. Pickle juice, pickle juice, pickle juice.
I wonder what's in these. No, stop, quiet.
Ah, okay.
What the
No,
hell?
There we go.
Oh, cow crap. There goes all my pickled pig's feet.
Pickled pig's feet. I hate vinegar, so anything that's pickled, yuck. Pig's feet or otherwise.
Going down.
Looks like your torch is getting a little dim there, Miss Pickford.
It's still hot enough to bring down this little bit of Gomorrah, Tannen.
Mary Pickford?
And then if you put that bag here, that'll allow the pallet to on the other side to stay up. But how do I reach it, though, now? It's not letting me cross. Is it? Never mind. Okay, that's something.
What was that noise?
What noise? I didn't hear a noise.
What do I do now? Okay, hold on. Let me get back downstairs. Can I knock this post over?
A 100 years from now, Hill Valley will erect a statue in my honor.
If you go through with this, there won't be a Hill Valley 100 minutes from now.
Hang in there, Doc.
Okay, another hint, perhaps, because I can clearly see that this thing is stuck, but
maybe we can come to a more peaceable.
That post is preventing the barrel of pickle juice from reaching its destination. Yeah, I noticed. Close inspection reveals that the post is not yet nailed in place, but how to move it out of the way? I thought the plank that it's resting on, that if I like put some weight on it, but it didn't seem like I could click on it. Like, there was no interaction possible. Push on the loose floorboard behind the bar. That's what I did!
Solution, Mr. Tannen.
Keep your distance.
Or you mean this one? Yeah, I was trying to click. Well, yeah, I guess you guys can't see it because of the overlay, but there is one there in the bottom right corner. And then this one rests underneath it.
Okay, that was lucky.
Won't be long now.
We'll just see.
Okay, what now? If I was to go back up upstairs
right
now
head.
And jump on the chandelier maybe or something.
Are you here to haul me back to...
The ammo's in place. Now to pull the trigger.
Well, yeah, it's hanging from somewhere. I can see, but I can't quite see where the rope is going. Must be attached somewhere, but I can't quite tell. Or is it attached somewhere behind the bar counter?
The ammo's in place. Hang in there, Doc.
Mary Pickford?
Don't tell me that you're not traveling through time under a pseudonym, Mr. Carl Sagan.
Quit yammering, you two. Nothing worse than a chatty stink.
The trap is in place. Time to spring it. How? One object drops from the chandelier. The other will follow suit. Well, you want me to click on the sandbag from upstairs? Like, give it a kick or something? There are not a ton of possibilities, I guess.
Come on.
Got any last words?
I'll see you in hell, Tannen.
You first, lady.
Come on, you son of a...
What the frog?
Who the hell are you?
I'm the diversion, butthead.
My internet decided to just go to hell and come back. I'm sorry. For the boys. Now, is it working now, though?
Doc, she's gone. Edna's DeLorean.
We've got to stop her before she hits 88 miles per hour. Come on.
Ah, okay. Well, we just prevented Edna from setting the whole town on fire.
Nothing to be worried about. You're a smart woman with a strong
How was hell?
Compass.
Yeah.
You just need to think your way out of it. Oh, fudge!
Pretty warm down here, but it ain't sunny.
I think she's spouting euphemisms at us. Luckily, the road out of Hill Valley is still pretty rough in 1875. It's unlikely she'll manage
I should have brought a souvenir, but they took all my money.
How are we gonna stop her?
Good question. We can't risk injuring her or damaging the vehicle for fear of altering the timeline even further. Luckily, those diagnostic lights my alternate self put all over her DeLorean have given me an idea. Here, take these.
What are these?
Flux synchronization modules.
How do they work?
I generally use them for maintenance purposes, but we might be able to use them to sync up with the alternate DeLorean's diagnostic modules, thus making it possible to link both sets of time circuits and override the time destination of the alternate DeLorean. At least that's the theory, anyway.
That's a great plan, I think.
Best of all, we won't need to weld the modules to the frame. We'll just snap them over the diagnostic lights.
Wait a minute, Doc. You want me to go out there? How the heck am I supposed to do that?
Good question. Let me think.
The hoverboard.
A hoverboard!
It saved our hides a few times before, so it seemed like the appropriate tool to bring along for the job.
Sweet! Riding a bike.
Does it have the Mattel branding on it, like in the film, though?
One, two, three, jump!
Whoa.
They censored other brands, like Adidas. That was censored on Biff's clothes in 1986.
All you've got to do is attach the fluxing modules to those diagnostic
I guess they got the license for the film stuff, part of the soundtrack and all, but not all the brands featured in the original film. This?
I can't reach it from here.
From the back, then, perhaps. I know, there's the Mr. Fusion in the way. From here, then?
I can't reach it from here.
I just have to climb onto the top.
How?
Should I disable it?
Leave it alone. It's not a good idea to monkey with nuclear reactors.
Or maybe from this side? If I grab onto the Mr. Fusion from here, no?
Mr. Fusion!
He's so excited every time he sees it.
Mr. Fusion!
Well, I guess I could put one here.
All right.
Nicely done. Now, aim the thing toward the receiving dish.
I'll try, but it's getting a little bumpy out here.
Yeah, but I'm on it now. Not about to let me do it. Doesn't look like you can. Ah, okay. Oh, whoa. This is not great controls wise. Super floaty. Bit more to the left. Ah, but now I'm too far to the left. It's too floaty. Ah, okay. What down to the go? I said that. Rear bumper. Driver's side. But she's gonna see me.
Oh, get off!
Can I do something about that rear view mirror? Yeah, that's what I was about to say. She's not letting me go that way. Or can I go around? Block view with blacksmith sign. Yeah, true enough, I haven't used it up till now. Windshield wiper? When did I get that? I can't interact with the rear view mirror. Whoa. Ah, that broke the rear view mirror. Okay. I didn't do it on purpose. I didn't know that was gonna happen.
Those flames, they may be radioactive.
I don't even like crossing through normal flames.
Ah, now I'm stuck on this side of the car.
It's one of the flux emitters.
I still can't reach it.
I can't reach it from here.
We just had to climb onto the top.
Oh, I wish I knew how to do that.
Nope. I don't even like.
Well, can I just flip
flames.
And with the windshield wipe?
Unfortunate. I'd stay out of them if I.
Yeah, the wiper. Yeah.
Nice work, Mark.
Shouldn't it have a locking system or something to avoid that from happening while you're driving around in the vehicle? You accidentally clicked on the windshield wiper, and when you held onto it, he saw you and tried to get you off since you were holding onto it, and it got off. Yeah, that's how I got it, but I didn't do it on purpose at the time. So I wasn't really paying attention. I was trying to get to the antenna. Well, where the antenna is now. The flux emitter. Nice, nice, nice.
Made it.
Excellent. Now let's get that flux override module on before she starts making life difficult.
I she's been making it easy up till now?
Yeah, my words exactly.
Well, here goes nothing, Doc. Whoa!
Perfect! Now, aim the focusing towards the receiving dish on my DeLorean.
Receiving dish. Check!
You did it once already. Oh yeah, but your DeLorean isn't exactly staying in one place, Doc. Huh? Come on, Doc. For all intents and purposes, it's aimed right. Ah, okay. I was about to move it again, using the arrow keys instead. It's not yours.
I can't reach it from here. Mr. Fusion.
I wanted to grab onto it to hoist myself up on the roof of the car, but I guess I can't. By going through the front bumper, she saw me. She's not about to let me do it, I guess. Oh, by the way, this is the longest stretch of a straight road you've ever seen.
It's one of the flux emitters.
Not from here. Yeah, it's still not gonna work.
You from here.
You just have to climb on.
I would love to.
It's locked.
Or can I open the passenger door on the other side? I haven't tried that yet. Driver door.
It's locked.
No, both are locked. Okay. She opened the window a little. Would that do anything? Is it still open now? Ah, yeah. I don't really have any clear view of it now, though. Or can I talk to her? Should I?
Edna!
What?
Let me in!
You want in? Fine!
Ah, there we go. Nice, Monica.
Marty, are you alright?
That was the right thing to do. Can you go to the front from the right side? Well, I seem to be in the right spot now.
I can't reach it while the window's shut.
What?
Pull over!
No!
Did she open the...
Excellent, Marty.
I guess she did open the window. I just didn't notice. Can't quite tell, but I think it's a different brand now. It's not Mattel anymore. I was trying to have a clear view, a clear view of it. Stop moving, Doc. Well done, Doc!
Now what?
Now we
we take control of Edna's DeLorean with the flux synchronizers and... That's strange.
Oh, what's strange? What? What's up again?
According to these readings, the temporal cohesion of Edna's DeLorean is decaying at an alarming rate.
English, Doc.
We've got to get Edna home. Now!
Crashed into the police station. Officer Parker is gonna love it. I'm sure. At 88 miles per hour, she's dead. She should be. No airbags, looks like. She's swore, yeah.
I must be back in. Would you be kind enough to tell me what day it is?
She admit.
The day I place you under arrest for arson, resisting arrest, and being a general all-round pain in the ass.
What?
Okay. She admitted herself to being a hooligan, so.
Century.
Would you look at that, Edna Strickland, drunk as a skunk.
Bait? I'm a time traveler.
Sure you are. I'm loving this.
I'll prove it to you. Come with me. We can do the whole day over if you want.
They'll get together now.
We can start her and by kid. Drying you out. Come on, into the station with you.
You can bunk with me, doll.
I'd rather die. Stop it! Unhand me, you dolt!
She may find that they have more in common than she would have believed.
Yes, I suppose it is. You know, whoever said time heals all wounds didn't know squat about time travel.
What do we do about that, DeLorean?
No need to do a thing. Ever since we synced up the time circuits, the temporal breakdown in Edna's DeLorean has accelerated at an exponential rate. By my calculations, the timeline should catch up with it in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, now!
I guess it makes sense.
What the hell?
With the change that they made...
See?
The changes, this one was never built. Wait, the other one was built instead.
The timeline's not fixed yet. Look! Harry, you missed all the fireworks at the expo. Yeah, so I heard. Listen, I heard a rumor about you two.
I guess we gotta come clean. Ta-da!
Oh, they did get married in Reno.
Try to keep a secret in Hill Valley.
Well, you gonna congratulate us or what?
Then it's true. My grandpa's married the wrong grandma. I'm done for.
Hey, you feeling all right, kid? You don't look so hot.
She's the wrong woman. You're too young. It isn't right. What should I say? That's coming a bit too strong, perhaps. You're the wrong woman. You're too young.
Marty, you can't do this. You're not supposed to get married for another 5 years.
Well, I know Trixie and I were taking things slow.
But after that witch Edna got me fired with that postcard, we kind of accelerated things a little.
The postcard? Oh, man.
It isn't right.
It just isn't right.
Now, I know marrying a Canadian for a work permit isn't strictly by the book, but hey, sometimes you gotta go out on a limb for the ones you love.
Isn't he just the sweetest?
Am I fanning out? Okay, I could get away without saying you're the wrong woman.
Can you see through me?
Nope, never could figure you out. I thought you'd be thrilled for us.
You don't understand. You're supposed to marry Sylvia Miskin.
But I did marry Sylvia Miskin.
Wait, what?
You didn't think my real name was Trixie Trotta, did ya?
Don't feel too bad. It was kind of a surprise.
And Miskin was the name of the lady on the painting in the saloon in 1871.
Hey, how old do you think I am, kiddo?
But you're so... so skinny and blonde and...
Yeah,
you know,
it's
Oh my god. I've seen you naked. You're Sylvia?
You okay, pal?
Yeah, I'm fine. Great. You kids go off and have yourself a wonderful
I wonder what will have happened to Edna in the present. I don't know if they're gonna show it or not.
Come around to what? to approving your marriage. You seem kind of mad about it back at the high school.
Well, that was before I got a look at her.
I called it.
Besides, as my dear old father Seamus used to say, no sense in getting riled up over something I can't do nothing about. And honestly, now
Seamus
McFly. I can't imagine a better daughter-in-law than the charming Miss Sylvie here.
Aw, thank you, Dad.
As for you, stranger, I'll thank you to not go poking your nose in McFly family business.
It's been a pleasure, Agent Callahan.
Agent Callahan.
See you in the funny papers, Harry.
Goodbye, Grandma.
You know, I took some pictures of Trixie in 1931.
Hey, that's my grandma you're talking about.
All right. Back to 1985. So, is everything back to normal?
Here we are, back in good old 1986.
Oh yeah, 1986, May 14th, not 1985.
15th. Best to build in a little lag time. Gives you a chance to catch up.
See, I'm in the present, Grandma.
Still going on. Hey, don't you want to stay, Doc? You gotta stop the bank from selling off all your old stuff.
What are you talking about? Estate sale? Bank? I'm not dead, Marty. Clara and I are having a little garage sale, that's all.
Garage sale?
Oh.
You mean... Marty, you're back from your trip. Hello, Doc. Selling off the family treasures, eh?
Not quite, but I hope you find something you like.
Speaking of which, did you find what you were looking for? Yeah, I sure did. Great! Hey, is that a box of Asimov? Let me get this straight. Are you telling me you live here now? In 1986?
Well, naturally. Claire and I maintain a part-time residence here. Wasn't that the case when you left?
No.
Strange. I can't imagine not sticking around. After all, I've got my late father's foundation to supervise.
The change, because now he gets along with his father.
Scholarship for young scientists.
When he didn't before.
Something funny?
I'll explain it to you later.
Yeah, Panda.
I don't see what's so funny about looking after a family legacy. Oh, almost forgot. I've got something for you.
Yeah, so there's a change. Everything is not quite back to normal, but it's a bit better than what it used to be.
Graduation? But that's not for another. The McFlys of Hill Valley.
An exhaustively detailed history of your family. From your great-great-grandfather Seamus to the present.
You traveled through time to write this?
Well, most of the research was done traditionally, but your grandma Sylvia proved to be something of a mystery.
Which is why you traveled back to 1931 to look for her.
Exactly. Who knew she was sitting
there? That was the reason for him traveling back to that time period in the first place.
The least I could do for the man who saved me from making the worst mistake of my life.
Yoo-hoo! Dr. Brown!
Edna Strickland.
Edna?
Ah, there she is. Wait, she hasn't... Ah, okay.
What's going on? What are you doing with my dog?
The same thing I do every afternoon, silly man. Giving him such much-needed exercise. Isn't that right, Einstein?
She's married to Kit Tannen. Please tell me... Oh, yeah.
It's time for our 3:30.
Coming, sweetie. Oh, Mr. McFly, have you seen my stepson anywhere?
They had a lot in common after all.
I think you're late for an appointment.
Oh, gosh. You're right, Mr. McFly. Hi, Marty.
Don't they make a great little family? You'd never know they met in prison.
Don't say anything. Let's just walk quietly into the lab and hope there are no more surprises.
Yeah, it's too much hassle to go back in time and fix that now. She is happy now, though. Yeah. I guess she is. Oh, what's happening? More surprises.
Doc!
Marty, what are you doing here?
You gotta come with me, back to the future.
Marty, you can't be here. If your younger self sees you, the consequences could be catastrophic.
My younger self? Oh, right! Bring him along, too!
This concerns all of us!
What do you mean? Does something happen to us?
Do we turn into assholes?
I love it.
We're fine. But our great-great-grandkids?
What the hell?
Great Scott!
All the same lines from the end of the first film.
Doc, you gotta come back with me. Back to listen to him, Doc. It's me you gotta help. If you wanna save Jennifer and our 12 kids.
What? 12 kids?
That's time I was overwritten 5 jumps back.
Doc, how can there be 2 more of me here?
I have no idea. By all rights, the space-time continuum should be tearing apart like a cheap dish rag right now.
It already is. What my evil twin and I are trying to say is the future is totally jacked up, and you gotta come with me to save it. No, me! So, we meet at last. You've altered my timeline once too often.
What's going on, Doc?
Well, we do seem to have a conundrum on our hands, or three.
Yeah, Doc, but which one is the real me?
No time to catch a break.
Isn't it obvious, Marty?
There's only one real you.
Prepare to be erased. Doc, wait! What about the space-time continuum?
Yeah, what about my future?
And mine?
The future can wait. We've got a present to catch up with.
Where to, Doc?
Mr. McFly, thrill me.
They never made a second game, though, so, there's no answer to this. And that was Back to the Future, the game. Too many timelines, yeah. I still haven't been struck with a copyright strike by YouTube or Twitch over the licensed music, but, like, fingers crossed. Let's leave it that way. Apparently, Twitch is coming down harder on people who stream anything that is licensed or something. After like 3 warnings, they can erase your channel, so you gotta be careful about that. Yeah, it's confusing, I know. I guess they could have left it there without inducing this little bit of mystery at the end, and it would have been fine. So tomorrow I'll get started on Disney's Epic Mickey. Now that we're done with this one. And like I said yesterday, if you like dark, gritty Disney stuff, then you should like that. You should like that. Wiley and Marty Future performed by Michael J. Fox. Yeah, that's what I said earlier. Nice. Oh, Young Emmett Brown is actually voiced by someone else? I couldn't tell. I just assumed that it was Christopher Lloyd managing to make his voice sound younger, perhaps, or something, but I guess maybe that was a bit too much. Sounded so similar though, yeah. It had me fooled. Yeah, I don't know how old Christopher Lloyd was already when they made this game, but I guess, yeah, that may have been a bit difficult. But just like they did for Marty, I guess the guy that they found is convincing enough. If you listen back to Michael J. Fox's voice from the first film, it sounds close. If you really pay attention, you can tell it's not the same voice, but if you don't overthink it too much. I should try to track down the animated show sometimes. Sometime in the future. I'd like to rewatch that. And I know it's not exactly considered canon, but there's probably never going to be a Back to the Future 4, so... Unless they reboot it, maybe, sometime in the future, I guess. But, I mean, I wouldn't be too surprised. Oh. To be continued, they say. Yeah, well, we're still waiting. Telltale Studios doesn't exist anymore, so, I don't know. Maybe never. It seems unlikely now, anyway. It's been 9 years. Well, I guess almost 10 years. 10 years this year. Speaking of which, I wouldn't be surprised, actually, if they re-release this sometime this year. Since it's been 10 years. Like, they're remaking all the Sam & Max games by Telltale. So, I mean, yeah, I guess this one is licensed. It's perhaps a license that's a bit harder to work around to make a remaster of this series. Before, I would hope, making a new one, but yeah, well... I won't be holding my breath, though, over this. But anyway, yeah, sometime in the future. Yeah, quote-unquote. And it is indeed a shame. I'll leave you guys to enjoy the rest of your night, then. Or the rest of your day, depending. And then I should be back tomorrow with Disney's Epic Mickey, then, which I hope everyone will be looking forward to, because it's a great game. And then after Disney's Epic Mickey, I think I'll move on to Fire Emblem 6, then. Like I said in my initial plan. That was my plan, anyway. You're welcome. You guys take care, enjoy the rest of your night then, and I should see you tomorrow. See ya. Peace. Yeah, you too. Have a good rest of the night. Good night, Panda.